In the next few videos, we're going to go over stoichiometry. This video is going to start by going over some of the basics, so looking at chemical formula, Avogadro's number, as well as the units that are commonly used in chemistry. So, to begin, chemical formulas essentially are for compounds, and there are two different types. There is the molecular formula and the empirical formula. The molecular formula shows the number of atoms in each molecule. So, for example, if we were to consider glucose, glucose has a molecular formula of C6H12O6. This means that each molecule of glucose has 6 carbon atoms, 12 hydrogen atoms, and 6 oxygen atoms. Another example would be ribose. So, ribose is C5H10O5. So again, that means for each ribose molecule, there are 5 carbons, 10 hydrogens, and 5 oxygen atoms. The empirical formula is the smallest integer ratios of atoms in a molecule. So instead of describing the number of atoms in each molecule, it tells you about the ratio of the atoms to each other. So for both glucose and ribose, they have an empirical formula of CH2O. Because for every carbon atom, there are 2 hydrogen atoms and 1 oxygen atom. So there's a 1-to-1 ratio. And you can see the same 1-to-1 ratio in both glucose and ribose. So essentially what this tells you is that there are multiple molecules with different molecular formulas, but the same empirical formula. However, not all molecules have to have the same empirical formula. Certainly, there are compounds like sodium chloride, NaCl, that would not have anywhere close to this empirical formula. Okay, so the next thing I want to talk about is Avogadro's number. Avogadro's number is important for looking at the number of molecules. So where it becomes important is looking at weight and mass. So first of all, the molecular weight. This is simply the mass of a molecule. And you can calculate the mass of a molecule by adding up the atomic masses of all the atoms that make up the molecule. So for instance, let's say we want to calculate the molecular weight of sodium hydroxide. Well, you can look at the periodic table. The periodic table will give you the values for the atomic weights for each of these elements. And using that, you can calculate what the molecular weight of sodium hydroxide is. So sodium has, according to the periodic table, an atomic weight of about 23. Oxygen is 16, and hydrogen is 1. So that means sodium hydroxide has a molecular weight of 40 daltons. So daltons are the units that we use for the molecular weight of molecules. Now, this is for a single sodium hydroxide molecule, 40 daltons. Usually in chemistry, when we're doing stoichiometry, we're dealing with a lot more than a single molecule. We're dealing with very large numbers of molecules. And this is where we need to discuss the mole. The mole is a basic SI unit for describing the quantity or the amount of a substance. It is equal to Avogadro's number of particles, molecules, or ions. Avogadro's number is 6 times 10 to the 23. So essentially it tells you if you have 1 mole of a molecule, that means you have 6 times 10 to the 23 number of molecules. So this is a very large number of molecules. The reason why Avogadro's number was developed is because it essentially gives us a nice translation between the molecular weight and the molar mass. So the molar mass is the mass of 1 mole of a compound. And the molar mass essentially is going to have the same number, numerical value, as the molecular weight, but the only difference is the units. So for example, if we wanted the molar mass of sodium hydroxide, it would be equal to 40 grams per mole. And we would calculate it essentially the same way we did with the periodic table. If you look at the periodic table, it tells you 1 mole of sodium has an atomic weight of 23 grams per mole, oxygen is 16 grams per mole, hydrogen is 1 gram per mole. You add them up, that will give you a molar mass of 40 grams per mole for sodium hydroxide. Okay, so finally, the last thing I want to talk about in this video are the units that you're going to see very frequently in chemistry. So for concentration, the units that we typically use are molarity. So molarity is denoted by a capital M, and a molarity is equal to moles per liter. Moles per liter, which we often just write as a mole over capital L, molarity. For pressure, there are several units that we use. For chemistry, the units that we use the most often are atmospheres. And this we'll use once we get to the videos looking at gases. 1 atmosphere of pressure is equivalent to 100,000 pascals, or 10 to the 5 pascals. We sometimes also use millimeters of mercury, as well as torrs. For volume, the unit that we often use is milliliters or liters. So 1 liter is equal to 1,000 milliliters. And another unit we'll occasionally use is centimeters cubed. So a centimeter cubed, or a cc, is equivalent to a milliliter. So 1,000 milliliters is also 1,000 centimeters cubed. Then we have temperature. Temperature, we use the Celsius scale or the Kelvin scale. So to convert in between these two, the temperature in Kelvin is equal to the temperature in degrees Celsius plus 273. So that would mean, for instance, at room temperature of about 25 degrees Celsius, that is equivalent to 298 Kelvin. And then molar mass, we've already seen, this is essentially the unit for the weight of 1 mole of a substance. This has units of grams per mole. So grams per mole. Okay, so these are some of the basics of stoichiometry, chemical formulas, Avogadro's number, as well as commonly used units in chemistry.